Hello there, survivors, and welcome back to another video on ARK Survival Ascended. Today, I've got another video about my modern tech ocean base that I've built here on the center, which is a perfect base for late game. You'll have plenty of space for all your storage, your crafting, and your water tames. There's a big water pen at the back of this design, and also some room inside the main cubes so you can easily breed dinos and have them all around while still being safe from the outside. The only downside that I just recently learned is you can't actually fit a chestasaur through a behemoth gate, which is quite a shame, because that means that either you have to leave it outside the water pen that I built, or you need to remove your front gate in order to make room for it to fit through. You could do that and then just add extra turrets to keep the entrance safe. It's all up to what you prefer. In this video, I'll show you a quick tour of the base if you haven't seen it yet, and then I'll do a full speed build of me actually designing this thing. Now, this won't be a perfect step-by-step kind of video, of course, because it's just me designing, so sometimes I have to redo stuff as I don't like it. Also, I'm mostly building one side and then of course skipping the other side, because otherwise the video would be very, very long. So for those people that really want to start building this and can't wait, this is how you can start get started on this build. But if you do not mind waiting a little bit longer, I am working on making a full build tutorial for this base so you can more easily follow how to build it step by step as well. So make sure you're subscribed, and if you want to see it early, you can consider becoming a YouTube member. It's the best way to support me, and tier 2 YouTube members get early access to every video that I post. With that being said, let's jump into the tour and the speed build afterwards. So there we go. This is my modern ocean tech base. I'm really happy with the way this turned out. It's got a couple of cool features. First of all, the two, well, technically they're A-frames, but also not, because they're kind of cubes, because they go down into the water the same amount as you can see above the water, which means you have a lot of space for some safe breeding inside of there as well. And then we've got the main middle bit as well, just as like a connecting piece, and also a different looking design. And of course, a big feature of this base is the water pen. We have a part here in the front with the entrance and a big water pen behind, so you'll have plenty of space even for chestas to start breeding them, or just keeping them safe if you're not using them. And as I said in the intro, the only downside is I recently just found out that you can't actually swim through a behemoth gate with a chesta. So you have two choices: either you leave your chesta outside and just make sure that it's protected in other ways, or of course we could remove the behemoth gate, make a bigger opening here at the front so that it can still swim in, and then you could park it there. And then probably you want to have a couple of extra turrets around to keep it all safe. Very unfortunate. It's currently the only way that we're gonna be able to fit it inside. It does fit in this height that I've built, so for the rest it should be good. Another little marker here at the front, you can see some vacuum compartments. This is to extend the foundations. You could also just build it on a bigger flat spot if you have the space, of course, just using normal foundation as for the rest of the build. But I plan on adding another build here down here, which is like an underwater base, which we'll be designing very soon as well. Now then, if we go into the base, you'll see this main part here where you can swim through. Then you can go left for a little breeding room. You can see some turtles here that I'm currently breeding with, or that I've just bred. And then on the other side, you have more space as well. So this is where you can keep your smaller to medium-sized water tames. And then here in the back, we have a giant water pen that easily fits a couple of chestas. This is where I've bred my chestas in. So yeah, definitely a big space to do everything that you need. And you can see there's also a couple of smaller normal gates here on the side, so you could also swim out with your smaller tames if you wanted to. But yeah, you just have a lot of space for water tames, which I guess is quite important if you're going for an ocean base. Now then, the main build itself, will not do a very detailed walkthrough. If you want to see that, I've got a video about that on the channel already. But yeah, we got the main room here that you can access from all the walkways around, where you can have a little bit of storage or power or whatever you want. You can go up to the next level as well, which has a nice little interior. Again, plenty of room. We got a little bedroom back here and then an elevator to the top, a hatch frame for if you want to drop stuff in or enter with flyers, a little balcony here out front, which is always nice, of course. And then mostly it just connects to all the other sides. So you can go to the other side buildings, you can go to the top here, park some flyers, have the transmitter. And then of course you can connect here. These are just walkways to the end. For example, more flyer parking if you would want to. And of course you could, if you need more space, turn this just in an entire floor. I didn't really use this, need the space, so I didn't use it yet. And then here we got another platform, and I've got some bees here, but you could also make like a little farm and plant some crops or something like that if you want to. There's plenty of options, there's a lot of space, and mostly just, yeah, the giant rooms. You have these hallways leading to the bigger A-frames where you have plenty of space. This is my dino site, so everything to hatch, breed dinos, as well as a bunch of cryo storage. So we can have everything nicely sorted, and then access to the water port as well, where you can keep your water tames again. And then here at the end, you have just a little platform to land flyers or to fly into your base with a flyer as well. If you want to go inside and drop off some materials, I have some ladders around the base in multiple places to make sure that you can always get out if you do fall into the water. And then here on the other side, we basically have the mirrored of the other side, but here I've done a crafting area with everything that you could need. You can of course add more storage or decorate it differently, and as I said before, you could even add another floor to this if you need even more space in your build. So yeah, that was a quick walkthrough of the base. As I said before, if you want to see it in more detail, I've got a detailed tour on the channel already. And then it's now time for the speed build. So if you want to try and build this base already, you can go ahead. But as I said, I will be working on a full step-by-step tutorial as well that will be coming out as soon as possible.
Thank you. Thank you.
that's going to be it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I hope to see you around in the next one. Goodbye.